Hi guys, welcome to Gatematic. In the previous lecture, we have covered the introduction to inverter, and also at the end, I have given you the homework in which you need to find the ratio of RMS value of all harmonic component with respect to fundamental, where V naught of T is given something like this. You all guys have liked that video and given me the feedback in the comment. So for that, I really appreciate you. And some of the students have given me the answer of these questions, like the answer of this question is 1 by 3 plus 1 by 5 plus 1 by 7, like this up to infinite, they are saying, or up to 0, and they are writing like this. Now tell me, if this will be asked in GATE exam in numerical answer type question, then what will the answer? Will you write like this? No, you cannot write like this. So I am not saying you to give the answer like this. I am saying you that you should give me the answer like you will give in the GATE exam. Okay, so you have to give the answer up to 2 places of decimal or up to 3 places of decimal. Now I am going to solve this question. I am sure you will laugh after seeing the answer. Okay, so let's proceed. In this question, it is peak value of voltage 100 volt, frequency is given 50 hertz. Find the ratio of RMS value of all harmonic component with respect to fundamental. So whenever the square wave voltage is given, then the Fourier series expression of that wave voltage will be that we have discussed in the previous lecture. So what is this? This is V naught of T is nothing but plus fifth harmonic output voltage, like this, and so on. Okay, I need to find the RMS value of all the RMS value of all harmonic component with respect to fundamental. So what is the value of V naught RMS here? The V naught RMS, since all having different frequency, so V naught RMS will be equal to the phasor sum of V01 RMS plus V03 RMS, and this will be phasor sum. Now you can see that both sine wave, every sine wave is having different frequency. One is having sine omega t, other is having sine 3 omega t, and other is having sine 5 omega t. So these all are orthogonal to each other. That means if I will have to find the overall RMS output voltage, then it will be equal to V naught RMS will be equal to under root of individual RMS, like this. Okay, so take under root here, it will be equal to V naught RMS ka square is equal to V01 RMS ka square, the RMS value of all the harmonic component. See what is saying, the RMS value of all harmonic components. So I can write like V naught harmonic ka square, it will be something like this. Okay, so from here V naught harmonic ka square will be equal to V naught RMS ka square minus V01 RMS square. Is it fine? Now I need to find the RMS value of harmonic component. It will be equal to under root of V0 RMS square minus V01 RMS square. Now see the question, it is saying that the ratio of RMS value of all harmonic component with respect to fundamental, means I need to divide with V01 RMS in the LHS as well as RHS. It will be something like this. So see, VOH upon V naught RMS, what we are getting? We are getting under root of, this is nothing but total harmonic distortion. Okay, so question is saying to find the total harmonic distortion of this square wave in different sentence, like find the ratio of RMS value of all harmonic component with respect to fundamental. So RMS value of all harmonic component with respect to fundamental will be equal to total harmonic distortion. So you don't need to do these all calculation, and you don't need to do these all things. If you understood the question, then you can easily say that this is asking about the THD, and I have already explained you that the THD of a square wave is equal to 48.43%. It is independent of the peak value of output voltage. That is what professor from IIT do. They generally change the sentence. Okay, they ask the same thing, like they are asking THD, but they reframe the questions in the form of sentence, and they will ask you to find that. If you understood the questions, then you can easily say the question is asking about the THD. So without using pen and paper, you can easily tick on 48.43%, but the answer of this is not 48.43%. It will be equal to 0.4843, because here it is not asking in percentage, it is asking in point. So overall the answer of this question will be equal to 0.4843. So some of you have given the correct answer, but some of you have given like this, some of you have given the unity one, some of you have given 0.91. So that is the reason I asked you to give me the feedback in the form of answer. If you'll give me the feedback, then you will get benefited. How? See, you have given the answer. I saw the different answer given by the different student, and based on that, I have given you the solution. So it will help you. That's why I'm saying you should give me the feedback. You should like this video, you should dislike this video. Based on that, you should interact with me. I'm making the today lecture, that is the single phase half bridge inverter containing R load, that is the resistive load. So after completing this lecture also, give me the feedback. Write down in the comment whether you have understood the concept or not. So answer of this question will be 0.4843. Now let's start this lecture, that is single phase half bridge inverter containing R load. This is the circuit diagram of single phase half bridge inverter containing two switch S1 and S2. This S1 and S2 are the bidirectional switch, means it may be like thyristor in parallel with diode. This is the bidirectional switch, or you can use the IGBT as well as MOSFET. Why we are using the bidirectional switch, that we will see in the next lecture when inductive load is taken or any RL load is taken. Okay. In this lecture, we are going to see the resistive load. Now see what is happening here. Two switch are operated in complementary fashion, means when S1 will be on, then S2 will be off, and when S2 will be on, then S1 will be off. So I am considering that S1 is on from 0 to T by 2 and S2 is on from T by 2 to T. Now let us consider what will happen when S1 will be on. When you will close this switch, then apply KVL in this loop. If you will apply KVL, then it will be equal to minus VDC by 2 plus V naught is equal to 0. So from here I am getting V naught is equal to VDC by 2. So output voltage will be equal to the supply voltage, that is equal to VDC by 2. So you can see from 0 to T by 2, this is my T by 2, output voltage is equal to supply voltage, and peak value of output voltage will be equal to VDC by 2. Okay. So this I will get when S1 will be on. Now see what will happen when S2 will be on. When I will close this switch S2, then apply KVL in this loop, it will be minus VDC by 2 minus V naught is equal to 0. So from here V naught I am getting, that is equal to minus VDC by 2. So from T by 2 to T, the output voltage I am getting, that is equal to minus VDC by 2, like this. Peak value is minus VDC by 2. So this is my instantaneous output voltage waveform at the output of inverter terminal. Now in the previous lecture we have already seen that how to draw the Fourier series of a square waveform, how to draw the fundamental component of any square waveform. These all things we saw in the previous lecture. Now here resistive load is taken, means what will be the value of I naught. So I naught of T, since it is voltage stiff type of load, R load is the voltage stiff type of load, so waveform of I naught of T will follow the V naught of T without any deviation, only the peak value will change. So I naught of T will be equal to V naught of T upon R. So similarly I naught of T I will get something like this, whose peak value is equal to V naught of T upon R. Here peak value of output voltage is VDC by 2, so peak value of output current will be equal to VDC upon 2R. Okay, so these all things we know, we are expert in making the waveform. Now find the total RMS output voltage. So total RMS output voltage, I already explained you how to find the RMS value of any rectangular pulse. So RMS value of any rectangular pulse we can find, let us say this is VDC by 2. Okay, so square this waveform. If you will square this waveform, then it will be something like this, having peak magnitude, this is time period T, this is having time period T. After squaring, it will be equal to VDC ka square upon 4. The peak value will increase. Now find the average of this waveform. The average of this waveform will be equal to VDC square by 4 into T upon T. That will be equal to VDC ka square upon 4. So RMS, take under root, that will give you the RMS. So under root of VDC square upon 4, that will give you VDC upon 2. So total RMS output voltage is equal to, I am getting, that is VDC upon 2, that is equal to 0.5 VDC. Remember one point, that this is the total RMS value of output voltage. This is not the fundamental RMS value of output voltage. This is the total. So take this point number one. Now find the Fourier series of this output voltage V0 of t. So Fourier series, I already explained you in the previous lecture. Fourier series of any square waveform V0 of t is equal to summation of, it contains only odd harmonics 1, 3, 5 up to infinite, and it is equal to 4Vs upon n pi into sine n omega naught t, where omega naught is the fundamental frequency and this Vs is the peak value of output voltage. Now here peak value of output voltage is Vdc upon 2. So replace this Vs with Vdc upon 2, you will get the Fourier series of this single phase half bridge inverter, that is equal to 2 times of Vdc upon n pi into sine n omega naught t. So these two formula are very, very important. If you know these two formula, then you can easily find each and every parameter related to single phase half bridge inverter. I am going to derive at least 9 to 10 formula, and you don't have to remember those all formula. Only you need to remember this formula number 1 and formula number 2. Based on that, you can easily find each and every formula according to the concept given by me. Now, I told you that in every lecture of inverter, I will make the fundamental component of output voltage as well as output current. So how will I find the fundamental component? We know according to Fourier series, any square waveform or any kind of periodic waveform can be resolved into series of sine wave containing different frequency. That is what I am getting. V0 of t is equal to summation of odd harmonics 2 Vdc upon n pi sine n omega naught t. Now I need to find the fundamental component. Why I need to find the fundamental component V01 of t? Because this is my desired value. Okay, I cannot connect a load whose output voltage is square wave. So to make the fundamental sine wave, what I will do, I will attach a filter in the inverter circuit and I will remove non-fundamental component of current and voltage by using filter or by using PWM technique in order to get the fundamental output voltage. So fundamental output sinusoidal voltage, I can easily find by using this Fourier series by putting n is equal to 1. That will give me 2Vdc upon pi into sine omega naught t, where omega naught is the fundamental frequency. Similarly, I can find the I01 of t also. I01 of t is equal to V01 of t upon R, that is equal to 2Vdc upon pi R into sine omega naught t. I can write like this. Now I told you that I will draw the fundamental voltage waveform and fundamental current waveform so that you should understand how much deviation is there. This is the total output voltage and this is the total output current. But how the fundamental output voltage and fundamental output current look like? It will look like the sinusoidal wave having fundamental frequency same as the frequency of this V0 of t. So I am drawing the waveform of V01 and I01. So waveform of V01 and I01 will look like this. This is my waveform of V01, which is sinusoidal wave having fundamental frequency, and this is my maximum value of V01. I can say V01 max. I can write like this. Similarly, the waveform of I01t, that is the fundamental component of current, I can draw. This will be like this. Is it fine? And this will be my I01 max. And in the previous lecture, I told you that the peak value of fundamental component of voltage and current is greater than the peak value of output voltage and current. Okay, so from this expression, I can easily find the V01 RMS. V01 RMS will be equal to V01 max by root 2, that is equal to root 2 Vdc upon pi. I can write like this. Similarly, I01 RMS I can easily find, that is equal to Im upon pi, that is equal to root 2 Vdc upon pi r. I can write like this. So no need to by heart these all formula. If you know the Fourier series, then you can easily find the V01 t and V0 RMS and I01 RMS. These all things we have discussed in the previous lecture. So TSD I am getting one under root 1 upon G square minus 1, that is equal to 48.43%. So in all the single phase half bridge inverter containing any kind of load, the distortion factor and TSD will remain same. Now find the fundamental component of switch current. See, I am writing here IS01T. 01 means fundamental component. Okay, so this I01 of T I can easily find. See, from, let us consider this switch. Okay, so fundamental component of switch current, how will I find? See, when this switch will be on, and from where to where this switch is on? This switch is on from 0 to T by 2. I can write like this. So from 0 to T by 2, this switch current will be equal to the load current, I can say. So switch current will be equal to the load current from 0 to T by 2. And from T by 2 to T, this switch is on, S2 is on, S1 is off. So S1, I will not get the current in S1 from T by 2 to T. So from 0 to T by 2, I will get the switch current. This is my T by 2, and that is equal to I0. Now I need to find the fundamental component of switch current. That means I need to find the I0 1. Okay, these two are equal because we are dealing in fundamental. So IS01 must be equal to the I0 01. So I0 01 I have already drawn here. So IS01 will follow the I0 01 from 0 to T by 2. Okay, and after T by 2, this switch S1 is getting off. So when it will be off, then I will not get the switch current of S1. So from T by 2 to T, I will not get any current. Similarly, you can draw the waveform of switch current S2 also. The waveform of switch current S2 will be from T by 2 to T, and average value and RMS value will remain as it is. Both are equal because I am dividing the time in two equal halves. Okay, so I am interested in finding only one switch current, that is IS01, and fundamental component of this switch current. Remember one point, this is the fundamental component of switch current, not the total switch current. If I need to find the total switch current, then it will be equal to I0 only. And here I0 I have drawn with blue pen. So switch current I will get from 0 to T by 2, something like this. Okay, and the peak value will be equal to I0 RMS. This is my I0 RMS, and this is my I01 maximum value. Like this. Are you getting this? Once you have drawn the waveform, then you can easily find each and every parameter asked in question. Got it? Now see the diode current. Will I get the diode current here in R load? No. In R load, in resistive load, we will not get the diode current because current in diode will flow opposite to this, and here R load is connected, means this load will not deliver power to the source for any time. Okay, so here diode current for all time will be equal to 0. So diode current will be equal to 0. When I will consider the L load or RL load, then I will explain you how the diode current is flowing. But for resistive load, diode current will be equal to 0. Got it? So I have drawn the waveform of V0 of T, fundamental waveform of V0 of T, waveform of I0 of T, fundamental waveform of I0 of T, as well as waveform of switch current, or you can say supply current, and fundamental waveform of switch current and supply current. I have drawn each and every waveform. Now based on that, I would like to explore single phase half bridge inverter by different formula. Okay, because in exam they will ask you anything. So what you have to do, you need to remember these two formula. I will say only to remember these two formula, and based on these you can find this one, you can find this one, you can find this one, you can find this one. So no need to by heart this. Only you need to by heart this formula and this formula. Now once you have drawn the waveform, then let us find each and every parameter that is needed in single phase half bridge inverter. Whatever I am going to find, that is really very important for you, because in GATE 2018 they have not asked any single question from inverter. So I am expecting that in GATE 19 they will definitely ask a question from inverter topic. So I am not skipping any concept related to inverter. That's why I am deriving each and every parameter related to this topic. So let us find each and every formula. I told you that you need to remember this point number 1 and point number 2 in order to find each and every formula. So V0 RMS in single phase half bridge inverter, I will get that is equal to VDC by 2, and Fourier series expression of V0 of T and I0 of T will look like this. In the same way, we can find the fundamental output voltage and fundamental output current, and we can draw the waveform like this. Okay, now I need to find the average switch or source current and RMS switch or source current. Here see, switch current and source current both are same. That's why I am saying that either you can find the average switch current that will be equal to source current only. So in order to find the average switch current or RMS switch current, what you have to do, you have to see the waveform switch current. See, I am not here talking about the fundamental waveform. I am talking about the average switch current. It is asking only average switch current, not the fundamental component of average switch current. So what you have to do, first draw the waveform of switch current. So switch current you will get, if I will consider only S1, so from 0 to T by 2, you will get the switch current, and from T by 2 to T, you won't get switch current, and the peak value will be equal to I0, that is the RMS value, that is equal to V0 upon R, and V0 RMS I already know, that is equal to VDC upon 2R. So this is my switch current waveform, or you can say the supply current waveform. Both are same in single phase half bridge inverter. Once you got the waveform, then you can easily find IS average, that is equal to I0 is the peak value, from where to where it is conducting. It is conducting from 0 to T by 2 upon total time period, that will give you the I0 upon 2. Similarly, IS RMS you can find, that is equal to I0 upon root 2. Now derive the fourth point, that is the fundamental average value of switch current and fundamental RMS value of switch current. See, here fundamental is asked, so which waveform we have to see? We have to see this fundamental waveform. So fundamental waveform of switch current I will get from 0 to T by 2, and it is following the sine wave. So first draw the fundamental waveform of switch current, and this is my I01 max. Is it fine? So I can say IS01 average will be equal to, see, this is the output of half wave rectifier. Okay, so we know output of half wave rectifier is equal to Im by pi, that is equal to I01 max by pi. This is the basic. You don't have to do the mathematical operation. If you want to do mathematically, you can say I01 average, that is equal to 1 upon T, 0 to T by 2, I01 max sine omega T d omega T. Okay, find the average like this, you will get this one only. Similarly, you can find the fundamental RMS value of switch current. Again, RMS value of this half wave rectifier output current will be equal to the Im upon 2, that is equal to I01 max upon 2. How you can find? You can find like this, 1 upon T, 0 to T by 2, I01 max sine omega T ka square into d omega T, and take under root of this. This will give you the RMS value. So if you'll do this, you will get this much only. So this I know, because this is the basic you will study in diode rectifier, in an analog electronics also. This much you should know. So do I need to by heart these all things? No, I don't need to by heart these all things. Only I need to plot the waveform. Waveform of fundamental component of switch current will be something like this. After plotting the waveform, I can easily find the average value as well as RMS value. And from where I will get I01 max? See the Fourier series. I01 of T is equal to 2 VDC upon pi R sin omega T. So this is nothing but I01 max only. Okay, this is my I01 max. So everything is related to Fourier series only. That's why I said that you should remember this point number 2 as well as point number 1. If you know this much, and if you know the waveform, how to draw the waveform of fundamental component and total output voltage, then you can easily find each and every parameter. Now fifth point is really important, that is the power across load due to fundamental. This is very, very important. Most of the guys don't know the difference between fundamental and total power. In inverter, they will frame a question, they will ask to find the power loss across load due to fundamental, or they will ask you find the fundamental power across the load. So fundamental power across load will be equal to P01, that can be written as V01 RMS multiplied by I01 RMS. These all are the fundamental, multiplied by cos phi 1. We know power is equal to VI cos phi. So do not write like this, P is equal to V0 RMS into I0 RMS into cos phi. Do not do this operation while finding the fundamental. Here fundamental power is asked, not the total power. This is my total power. Are you getting this? So we will not apply this formula. We will take the fundamental RMS output voltage and fundamental RMS output current multiplied by cos phi 1. Now see, this cos phi 1 is nothing but fundamental displacement factor. What do you mean by this? This I have already explained you in rectifier. Fundamental displacement factor is the cosine of angle between fundamental voltage and fundamental current. Now see the waveform. The angle between fundamental output voltage and fundamental output current is zero. It is also starting from zero and it is also starting from zero. So there is no any phase shift between V naught of t and I naught of t. According to this concept, I can say phi 1 is equal to the angle between V01 and I01. And it is equal to 0, so I can say cos phi 1 will be equal to 1. So here I can say the fundamental power across load P01 will be equal to V01 RMS multiplied by I01 RMS, or you can replace this I01 RMS with V01 RMS upon R. So it will be equal to V01 RMS ka square upon R, or I can write like I01 RMS ka square into R. Now, from where I can find the V01 RMS from Fourier series? See, this is my V01 of t. So I can easily say V01 RMS will be equal to Vm upon root 2. So it will give me root 2 Vdc upon pi. Are you getting this? So you can manipulate just by remembering the Fourier series. No need to by heart these all things. Sixth point is also important, that is the fundamental power delivered by each source. Means how much power this source voltage is delivering and how much power this source voltage is delivering. So see, from 0 to t by 2, this source is delivering power, and from t by 2 to t, this source voltage is delivering a power. And both power will be equal in magnitude. Hence, the fundamental power delivered by each source, I can write PS01. I have to use this suffix 01 because it is asking fundamental power. So PS01, how much voltage is here? This is the Vdc upon 2. Okay. So I can write Vdc upon 2. This is my voltage multiplied by the current. Now see here, supply voltage is DC. So what is the value of current here? Whether I have to take the RMS value or DC average value? I will take the average value. Why? Because here voltage is DC. So I have to take the average value of current, but here fundamental power is asked, so I need to take average value of fundamental switch current. Do not mug up these all things, try to understand the concept. Here fundamental power is asked, that's why I am multiplying the average value of fundamental switch current. Okay, and fundamental switch current I have already found from 0 to t by 2. It is following sine wave like this. This will be Vdc upon 2 only, and multiplied by, this will be equal to I01 max upon pi. Now you can manipulate this I01 max upon pi with this 2 Vdc upon pi r. I01 max is equal to 2 Vdc upon pi r, right? So I can replace this I01 max is equal to 2 Vdc upon pi r. It will be equal to Vdc ka square upon pi square r. So this is my fundamental power delivered by each source. So I can, if I will have to find the total fundamental power delivered by both the source, means I need to multiply this by 2. To get total fundamental power delivered by both the sources, you have to multiply this by 2. Then you will get this only. See, this one. That is the power across load due to fundamental. See, these two sources are delivering power to the load. So power delivered by these two sources will be equal to the power accepted by this load. Okay, so fundamental power delivered by these two sources will be equal to the fundamental power across load. That is what I want to say. If you multiply this by 2, then you will get this only, root 2 Vdc upon pi. This is my fundamental RMS output voltage ka square upon R. This will give you 2 Vdc square upon pi square R. So see here, fundamental power across load will be equal to the fundamental power delivered by both the sources. Fundamental power delivered by each source will be equal to Vdc square upon pi square r. Now for fundamental power delivered by both the sources, I have to multiply this by 2. So if you multiply this by 2, then you will get this only. Okay, so what is the conclusion? The conclusion is the fundamental power across load will be equal to the 2 times of fundamental power delivered by each source. I can write like this. Got it? Now see the seventh point. In seventh point, you need to find the total power across load. Now see, this is not asking the fundamental power, it is asking total power. So total power across load means we have to multiply with total RMS voltage into total RMS current into cos phi. And we know in total RMS voltage and RMS current, the power factor is unity because here resistive load is taken. So I can write V naught RMS into I naught RMS, or I can write V naught RMS ka square upon R, or I naught RMS ka square into R. I can write like this. Now I know V naught RMS is nothing but VDC upon 2. So it ka square upon R, that is equal to VDC square upon 4R. This is my total power across load. Remember guys, fundamental power and total power, both are different. Okay, so total power contains the harmonic power also, but fundamental power contains only by putting n is equal to 1. So total power is equal to fundamental power plus third harmonic power plus fifth harmonic power. So this is the total power across load, and in many question they will ask you the total power across load, then you need to follow this procedure. Suppose they are asking fundamental power, then you have to take V01 RMS into I01 RMS. Are you getting this? So this is very, very important. You should know the difference between total power across load and fundamental power. Most of the guys don't understand what is fundamental and what is total power. They apply the formula V0 RMS, I0 RMS in fundamental and they get the different answer, which is wrong. Okay, so you need to keep in mind. Now the 8th point is the last point, that is the total power delivered by each source. Okay, so total power delivered by each source, here the source is connected here. Okay, this is my source and I need to find the total power. So total power delivered by this source will be equal to voltage multiplied by this IS average, and this IS average is not the fundamental. IS average is the total IS average because I am interested in finding the total power. So what is the total power delivered by each source? PS will be equal to VDC by 2, that is the supply voltage, multiplied by IS average. And this is not the fundamental. Remember, first draw the waveform of IS. So waveform of IS will be something like this, from 0 to T by 2 and from T by 2 T, it will be 0. And this is my peak value, that is I naught. I naught can be written as V naught upon R. And V naught in rectifier is VDC upon 2R. Now find the IS average. IS average I have already found in point number 3, that is equal to I naught upon 2. Okay, so replace this VDC upon 2 multiplied by I naught upon 2. Now I can replace this I naught multiplied by V naught upon 2R. I can write like this. And now this V naught can be replaced by VDC upon 2. I know the RMS value of output voltage is VDC upon 2. So it will be equal to VDC square upon 8R. Okay, so total power delivered by each source is equal to VDC square upon 8R. Now see, one source is delivering power VDC square upon 8R and other source is also delivering power VDC square upon 8R. So total power delivered by the supply will be equal to twice of this, that is equal to VDC square upon 4R. Suppose the question is saying that total power delivered by this supply, means whole these two battery, that is the VDC by 2 and the VDC by 2, that is the total power delivered by these two sources, that is equal to VDC square upon 4R, and that is equal to the total power across load. See, VDC square upon 4R. So here also I can conclude that total power across load will be equal to 2 times of total power delivered by each source. I can write like this. Total power delivered by each source is this one. So if I multiply this by 2, I will get the point number 7. Got it? Now you will say that this much formula I need to remember. No, you don't need to remember these all formula. What you have to do, just draw the output voltage and fundamental output voltage. Draw the output current and fundamental output current. Draw the switch current or supply current and fundamental switch current and supply current. Okay, after drawing this, remember this point number 1 and point number 2, that is the total RMS output voltage of single phase half bridge inverter is 0.5 VDC and Fourier series is something like this. Once you know the Fourier series and V0 RMS, then you can easily find the average switch current, RMS switch current, or average source current, RMS source current, like this, just by drawing the waveform. In the next, see, fundamental average value of switch current is asked. So I have drawn the fundamental waveform of switch current. So depending on the waveform, we can easily find each and every formula. Only you need to remember formula number 1 and formula number 2. Rest you can derive according to the question given. So let us take one question. Question is saying a single phase half bridge inverter containing R load, here resistive load is given, having R is equal to 10 ohm and each source is having VDC by 2, that is equal to 100 volt. You have to find the fundamental displacement factor first, second fundamental power drawn from each source, fundamental load power, total power drawn from each source, and fifth is total load power. So you have to find these all 5 points and you have to write down on comment, YouTube comment. Okay, how will you write? You can write like this: point number 1 answer, point number 2 answer, point number 3 answer, point number 4 answer, and point number 5 answer. So write down your answer in the comment below so that I will have a rough idea whether you understood the concept or not, and based on that I will explain this homework in the next lecture. Got it? Please like this video, also share this video with your juniors, also solve this homework and write down the answer of this all question in YouTube comment. This is really important. I need feedback from your side. Got it? For doubt solving, you can join our Facebook group.